Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. This is 1.5 of the Google site tutorials using the Google training framework. So today we're going to talk about how to add, reorder, and nest pages. Pages show up here on your Google site. Before we jump into that, you'll see that I've spent a little bit of time just customizing some of the information here as if it were going to go live. It's not actually live yet. So I've got my little tagline here that you hear in every video and all those different things. And in a little introductory paragraph for people when they come to the site, I've linked to the YouTube channel here where all these videos will be housed. But what we're gonna focus on today is we're gonna focus on pages. So the important thing about pages is it's a way to separate information for different groups of people, and how you order those pages is important, but also how you nest those pages. When we talk about nesting, we talk about how they stack on top of each other. For example, if I had a schedule page here, I could have another page underneath it that would say ninth grade schedule and then eighth grade schedule. Right? So it's all under the same page, but it's nested under different pieces of information. Another way to look at that would be maybe short stories. So if I was a language arts teacher, which I was, and I had, you know, mystery, I could have short stories, then a subheading or a sub nest, if you will, that said mystery or romance, action, classics, modern, you know, different types of short stories, and I could have those all nested under one page. So the way that we're going to do this, let's jump in. You can see it, it's right over here. We're going to go over to pages, and you'll see a big plus sign right here. So we're actually going to create a new page, and this new page is going to be called 1.5 add reorder. And actually, I'm not going to call it 1.5 because we want to make sure that the nest is correct. So the overall is getting started with sites. And I'm using the Google framework, right, that they have on their site. And when I click on advanced, I can do a custom path, which we'll talk about a little bit later. But the first thing I want to do is just create this page. So when I'm done, I click done. And what you'll see now is I have this new page here that's already pulled in all of my fonts. It's pulled in my background image. It's pulled in my color scheme or my theme for the website. Now, what I would want to do with this on Get It Started with Sites is I could have pages underneath this that said 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5. I don't know if I need to go that in depth with this, but I could right here add some information. You'll see that the sections are already here. And I would go back and add those later when I wanted to insert, which we'll talk about later. But there is my page, okay? Now, if I want to reorder my pages, right, we would just grab this, oops. We go back to pages, it's of course, because I'm, and here is where I would grab and reorder them. So you'll see that home is on top and it's gonna go left to right, top to bottom. As I move these around, I can reorder these pages. And I can do this anytime that I want. It does not have to be before we publish the site or make the site live. I don't have a newsletter, right? So I'm going to delete the newsletter page, right? Now, if I want to nest these pages or make them stackable, I am going to click on this and drag it. And you'll see now that the schedule drops right underneath getting started with sites. What you'll also see has happened to my menu up here, my page menu, is I have a little caret, right? When I click on that, I can click on schedule and it will take me to that nested page. If I want to unnest that page, and I want to grab it and then move it out of the nesting. So these are now equal pages. Okay. Under pages, right, what I can do is I can actually duplicate the page. I can set it as the home page. I can rename the page. I can create a subpage or hide the subpage if I wanted to, and I could completely delete that page from the site. So let's look at getting started on all those options. So the first thing is I want to make this the home page. So now when people log on or go to Google site, right, this, when I share it, this is what they're going to see on the home page, not the actual home page, right? So I'm going to make the home page the actual home page. You can only have one home page at a time, unfortunately. It's actually not unfortunate. Having multiple home pages confuses people. I can duplicate the page. So when I click on the three dots and I click duplicate the page, it's going to give me a copy of that, which what this allows you to do is if you have similar pages in the way that you like the theme and the formatting and all of that stuff, you can duplicate it, then go back in and just change some of the font and some of the descriptions. So when I click on done, you'll see that I have copy the original. Now I'm going to delete this. So we'll delete that page. Okay, here's our home page again. Getting started with slides. We can rename the page here. Properties. And then this is where we would change the name. If I wanted to add a subpage, I could. When I click done, you'll see that this comes down on the drop-in menu. So there's a couple different ways to nest pages. So this is a subpage is now nested under getting started with sites. And this will all show up in your menu here. Okay, I'm going to delete this subpage. And then we can also hide this from navigation. So maybe I'm working on a page, but I'm not quite ready to publish it, and I just want to hide it so they can't see it. You'll see that I have the page. If I zoom in really quick, it has a line through it. When I click on these three dots, if we go back to full view, I can show in navigation again. So again, this has been 1.5 on the Google site tutorial. This is how to add, reorder, and nest pages. Again, I love you. I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.